Welcome to Mid-Ohio for the running of the 3M200. On the floor for today's race is Paul Macon, to the outside is TJ Hanley. Crash B Fan is third, fourth is Jay Parker, and fifth is Grace Ace Vito. So up front we have, in second, your second place points man. And in fourth we have the points leader, Jay Parker. As here we go, 14 laps around Mid-Ohio, the pace car is in. As they come down the front stretch, the green flag is in the air, and we're racing here at Mid-Ohio. TJ Hanley clears Paul Minnick, so a great run there for Hanley, a great start. The outside lane got a pretty good start. Here comes Jay Parker now underneath Minnick. He's going to probably grab that, although Minnick with a good run off the corner will keep it. Now 92 going to try and catch back up. And for TJ Hanley, right, he's second in points. Oh, look at Paul Minnick out wide. Ace of Vito out wide comes up into Levi Schoen's, no contact made. TJ Hanley right now leading this race. He's second in points. He needs a win, or he's going to need to get to that points lead. And with Barker running third right now, your points leader, that's not going to happen. So he's going to need to win because Richmond is coming up. And it's coming up fast. Look at Crash B Fan off course there. Got back on right in front of what looks like Tommy Turbo there in the 70. It's the front few keeping their calm. Oh, John Gambit out wide. Grace Ace Vito going to take advantage of that and hope to grab that spot. Doesn't look like he'll be able. Oh, nope. John Gambit on the inside. So to complete lap points, TJ Hanley out front. He leads lap number 1 of 14. He has a pretty good lead over Paul Macon. This is what road courses are. Track position big up front. It doesn't look like we're seeing any battles right now, although Levi Schoen's running eighth. Michael Gregory is ninth, right in the back bumper of him. Might be looking to the inside right here. Nope. See if we go back and find any battles here. Go kind of through the field, see where everyone is. See, Riley Sprague has been on a pretty bad streak of races. As he goes out wide there, but he's been on a pretty bad streak lately where he actually lost the points. He's down to, I believe, fourth in points. Now he won. Whoa! Dan Bandon out wide along with Dale Petty. They get back on track. They save it. See, that is the 33 of Keith Powell. And you got the 5 of Jeff Bright right behind. Bright, season 1 champion of this series. And he hasn't had a good season thus far. Well, it's been a pretty good season, actually. He just hasn't been able to capitalize and win to get into the chase. He's actually in the top 10 points as we speak. Oh man, these guys getting a little bit aggressive around the top 15. So we go back up to the front. It's still TJ Hanley out front. He leads lap number 2. This is what Hanley kind of wants too. Although, you know, he's looking for a win, obviously, because he's out front. This is the second race in a row now he's out front. But as he's thinking about points, when you're out front, you're thinking about a win, obviously. You're always thinking about a win, but if you're TJ Hanley and you don't have a win, and you know you're within range of the points lead, you could be sometimes thinking about, hey, do I make this 3-wide move or not? You know, that's what this has come to with the 44, 19, and the 5 up there in points contention to get to the points lead and not have a win. They would make it into the chase with the points lead, as points lead overrules wins, as I've mentioned. See if a little bit of a flyby here. See the cars coming up there. John Gammon and Grace Ace Vito pretty close. But so, you know, TJ Hanley up front, obviously he's hoping for a win, but say the 15 catches him in the next few laps, Hanley's not going to block and wreck himself. He's going to let the 15 go and say, you know, if I gain some points on the 15 or on the 92, I'll be fine. 92 right now running third. Jay Barker having a pretty good run after winning the first race of the season. He's been on a march. And right now, third, leading the points by, I think, about 76, 72, somewhere around there. TJ Hanley completes lap 3. There is 11 laps to go at Mid-Ohio. We go back through the field. See Jeff Bryan, Chris Dodd pretty close. That's for 16th. Bright gets the position. Now Dodd does a little bit of a crossover there. He had a good run. Jeff Bryan the outside of this corner. No! Chris Dodd gets it. So Chris Dodd to the 16th position. He passes Jeff Bright. Go back up to the top 10. See, the front three really spread out, even front 4 or 5. That's kind of closer behind. You see, Luke Rainey in 10th, a good run for him. He has not had the best of seasons. He hasn't won a race, but there are still some tracks coming up where he can win. Obviously, Bristol is before the chase, and he's won in the Target Series before at Bristol. He won there and beat out TJ Hanley in season number 2. Basically, last lap pass, what you could call it, the last lap before the caution came out, he was able to pass TJ Hanley. Actually put TJ in the wall there. They were teammates at the time. Grace Hatesfield gets to 6th, possibly. Oh, Levi Shones way out wide. And John Gamet's still fighting with Grace Hatesfield. Shones is going to be able to keep his position. Whoa! John Gamet got really loose. That was a cool camera position there. Look at that. Yeah, Luke Rainey, I think, can still get into the chase. He just needs some good runs, which he's been having the past few races. In fact, he was in a position to get a top 15 at Indianapolis until he got wrecked on the last lap. They come 10 laps to go right here. And Rainey is a really good driver. We've seen it in just problems with the team possibly this season. Maybe not what they liked. And they might have changed some stuff, and now it's working pretty well. As you can see, he's been running in the top 10, top 5, top 15 for a lot of these races lately. Just outside of the top 20 points, but I think if he can break into the top 20 and get a win, he can get into that chase. I don't think his chase ups are done yet. So look back up front. Minnick has closed in on TJ Hanley just a little bit. His last lap was a little bit faster than Hanley. But is it enough is the question. Once you start catching, do you overdrive the car like he just did? Paul Minnick out into the dirt just a little bit. Well, keeping it green, let's go through the field here as we have time to do it. 14 lap race and we're only on lap 5. See, TJ Hanley is out front after starting 2nd. He has a pretty good car right now, just hoping to keep that lead. Get to victory lane here at Mid-Ohio. In 2nd we have Paul Minnick, who started on pole. He's just right now in 2nd, right behind TJ Hanley, just trying to keep his position and hope for another caution, get another shot. Jake Barker, your points leader, is 3rd. Having a pretty solid day so far. Top 3 the whole day, started 4th. And a good run for him. See, Crash B Fan is in 4th. That 20 car been silent. Nothing said over the radio. In 5th, we have Tommy Turbo, who's not had the best of seasons. Right now, running 5th, the top 5. That could propel this team up. I don't know if they can make the chase, but get some wins, you never know. In 6th, we have Grace Acevedo, who last season's champion. Won at Talladega earlier this season to lock himself into the chase. He has had a pretty consistent season so far. He's looking to add to it with another great result here today. In 7th is John Gamet. He didn't start off the season on the right foot, and he hasn't really found the right footing as he is towards the bottom of the points list, but he's just staying in it. And right now running 7th. Levi Shones hasn't had the best seasons either. He's right now running in 8th. Pretty good run for that 4-3 team. That's exactly what they needed. Michael Gregory is 9th after winning at Kentucky. Right now he has a win, but he's outside of the chase because there are right now 12 winners in the top 20. He's not in the top 20. He's right now the 13th winner. So he needs to get up there or get another win. Luke Rainey, as we mentioned, in 10th. He's had a pretty mediocre season, but I could say. 11th, Riley Spurley, too. He's led the points pretty much all this season until Daytona, where he had that save, and then he was involved in the big one at the end. And then he's had some bad races since then and moved him down from the points lead to 4th, I believe. In 12th, they have Dan Bannon. He's been pretty quiet all season. And same here today, running 12th, pretty quiet, but a nice solid result. 13th, Jason Smeal Jr., while his teammates up front leading, he's running 13th. He's also 3rd in points, right behind TJ Hanley, who is 2nd. And the car feels good right now. He just needs that track position. Everyone needs that. In 14th, we have Keith Powell in the 33 at Home Depot Chevrolet. And right now I'm running pretty quietly in the top 15. Dale Petty is 15th. Chris Dye is 16th. Jeff Bright, season 1 champion, is 17th. And just still looking for that first win this season. He needs it to get into the chase. Eli Bright, his son, has 3 wins this season. 3 of 5. He actually won 2 in a row, and then he won 3 in 5 races. So car handling good for Jeff Bright right now, just like others need the track position. Derek Bouchard, dead at the bottom of the points list, right now running 18th. 19th is Jack Marshall, and 20th is Alex Stewart in that 18 car, who has a win, but he's 33rd in the points, so he needs to get up above the top 30 and then get within the first 12 winners. 21st, Jonathan Buford. 22nd, Timothy. 23rd is Jim Gamet, who won at Las Vegas earlier this season, locked himself into the chase. He's had a good season so far. 24th is Jonathan Raines, who won at Rockingham, but he's towards the bottom of the winners. He is in the chase right now, but he needs to keep it that way. Tyler Lyman is 23rd. 5th. And 26th is Tim Gary. And 27th is Kevin Ban, who has had a pretty bad season thus far as we are coming to halfway. 28th is Hunter Arnstorf. See the 54 junior rounds out because of a clutch. We'll look at this leaderboard right here. Keep that up. 29th is Griffin Lin in the 32. Won two races this season, so I believe he's pretty well into the chase as long as he stays top 30. Same with Eli Brighton, 30th, who won three races this season at Charlotte, Dover. Those were back-to-back. And then Daytona after a wild last lap. In fact, he and Griffin Lin went five races as they were the only two winners. 31st, Bray Ernest almost won at Indianapolis last race. Problems on the last lap after he passed TJ Henley. Got too wide in turn three, and that's what cost him. 32nd is Gary May, who has had a quiet season. 33rd, Hunter Bob. 34th, Anthony Wendler, who won earlier the season at Bristol. However, he's 38th in the points. That has not been a great season for Wendler, and that is why he is not in the chase. As Hunter Bob got the wall in front of him, he's going to gain position right there as Bob falls back. 35th, Josh Crash. See there, Crash trying to complete the pass on Hunter Bob after the 34th, the wall. As the sixth car actually won at Atlanta. As he goes way wide. Jay Jefferson in 36th. He had a great middle of the season stretch where he's finishing top 10, top 5, so pretty much every race. He won at Richmond. So he goes off track here. And now he's just kind of been fading, and he can't do that because the chase is coming up, and if he falls below where the winners are, that's going to be problems. In 37th, we have Trey Rainey, who's not had a great season and just hoping for good results now. And in 38th, round out the field on track is Jason Smith Sr. as Junior Ramos is off track as we look up front. And it's TJ Henley still out front with six laps to go. And he's trying to just make it to the end. He has led every lap thus far, keeping Paul Mack behind him and just hoping for no cautions, hoping for nothing weird to happen. See, the dust from where all the cars got off the track there. See, the field is really spread out. 10th place is 10 seconds behind TJ Henley. So that just shows how much track position means here at road courses. And I think we have one more on the schedule. Only one more, and that is Old Spice coming up. And that is right before the chase. So that will be another place to try and get a win. As they come to the line, five laps to go for TJ Henley. See, he's dominated this race so far over Palmick, and the gap has stayed the same at 91 tenths. See, Tommy Turbo in fifth is pretty spread out. Grace Ace Vito is sixth. John Gambit, Levi Shones, Michael Gregory, Luke Green, top 10, and Riley Spurlytube. So, yeah, now the 22 is 10.25 seconds back. So, not a very exciting race, I will say, but a clean race, and probably what the drivers wanted after the last few races and how wild they have been. And especially with what's next on the schedule. Bristol is next. These drivers know what that means. It's going to be wild half-mile short track racing in the last great Coliseum. Nighttime, and oh man, it's going to be a wild race there. And as we mentioned, Luke Rainey has won there. Won there last season, the Food City 250. Or is it the Food City 300? I keep changing those names, I can't remember. But yeah, so Luke Rainey hoping to go back to victory lane there. Bristol actually won there earlier this season in the Gatorade Cup Series in that two car. He's not had the best season over there either, but Bristol can turn things around for him as he is very good there. And that is, he's looking forward to that race especially. But right now we're in top 10. He has to finish four more laps of this as these guys have already taken four laps to go. It's TJ Henley still out front of Paul Minnick. The gap down just a tenth there. See how far ahead the front four have gotten from Tommy Turbo in fifth. The gap actually from fourth to fifth is right now over 3 seconds. As Paul Mack has actually closed in on Henley just a little bit there. I don't know if Hanley's tires are falling away or what, but Mack just a little bit closer to Henley. That's not what TJ needs right there. As here at Mid-Ohio, one car does not start the race. Still trying to figure out who that is. Looking through. And it might be Timothy Heath in the 20. No, Timothy, I did a report on. Trying to see who did not qualify for today's race. We'll actually have that for you after the race, unless I can figure it out. So they're coming to three to go this time, and TJ Hanley's still up front. But Paul Mick is closing just a little bit. Will we have a last lap or last few lap drama here? The gap has just went down just a little bit. And those front four definitely have a gap on fifth on back. Shows what track position does here at road courses. And TJ Hanley just hoping to see the white flag soon. It's three to go. He just has to go three more laps and he wins here at Mid-Ohio, and it'll be his third career Target Series win. Won season one at Daytona Night. Last season he won at Charlotte and finished second in the points, very close there. This season looking for that win, and the one season where wins are the most important, he's seemed to find every way not to win this season. A lot of drivers have, and he's looking for redemption here today at Mid-Ohio, but Paul Minnick is closing in just a little bit. Last lap for Minnick was a little bit faster. Ooh, 15 way out wide. That's not going to help him. He definitely pushed the car hard. Here comes Barker, your points leader. Ooh, contact as they came from under the bridge. Minnick holds second, but that's not what they need to go battle in there and get off course. And TJ Hanley will take two to go this time with a pretty comfortable lead now. I bet it's over a second after all that happened behind him. Two laps to go at Mid-Ohio, so the caution comes out. The race is officially over, and the gap has increased to 1.5 seconds. He basically doubled the gap. And I believe I found out which car did not start. That's Jonathan King, who won last race at Indianapolis to lock himself into the chase. However, with him missing this race, it's going to put him on the brink of making the chase or not. Because if TJ Hanley wins today, that'll be his first win of the season. He's up ahead of King in points, and King falls down. I don't believe King's going to be in the chase after this, so it's going to be interesting to see what happens. And TJ Hanley looking for that white flag, looking to see one lap to go to win. 44 car just been so strong this season. Started out pretty strong. He kind of fell off in the middle months, or the middle races there. Now he's kind of fought his way back, and he's hoping that he's peaking at the right time. Same with Jay Barker, but Barker has been peaking the whole season. It's just been consistent. I believe he's been like top five pretty much the whole season. Here they come. From under the bridge. Hanley goes by. Palmate goes by. Minnick has closed it just a little bit. But he's going to have to find a huge way to get around TJ Hanley as they go through the final corner. Or, I guess, second to final corner. Here they are. The white flag for TJ Hanley one more time around Mid-Ohio. The 3M 200 coming down to it. Hanley up front. He's led 13 of 14 laps. He's looking to make it 14 of 14 right now as they go off of one. And TJ Hanley with a pretty comfortable lead of just under a second. Tommy Turbo has actually closed down these guys a little bit. So, possibly these guys have pushed harder. See Minnick driving the car hard. Stays a little bit higher than Hanley there off that corner, trying to get a run off. And all TJ has to do is just run consistent, smooth corners. He doesn't push the car too hard, because if he goes off track, that's it'd be devastating for him. No battles within the top four. No battles within the top five. I believe there's no battles within the top 10. As Hanley comes around, Paul Minnick trying to catch, but it's just not going to be enough for him. Here they are. They will approach the bridge this time. Minnick drives hard, trying everything he can. And approaching some of the final corners, TJ Hanley in the TH Designs Toyota for TriStar. Has to round two more corners. He's going to do it. TJ Hanley will win. For the first time this season, lock himself into the chase with the win in the 3M 200 at Mid-Ohio. Hanley wins, Minnick second, Barker third, Crash B Fan fourth, Tommy Turbo comes across fifth. But TJ Hanley gets it done here at Mid-Ohio, gets himself into the chase for season number three, and he will be a threat for sure. As Paul Minnick came up short, second, but a good run for Minnick after starting on pole. Hanley, though, just had a great start there at the beginning to get by. Let's check the finishing results. Here are the finishing results from the 3M 200 at Mid-Ohio. There were no caution flags and only one leader. That was TJ Hanley, who led all 14 laps en route to the victory. Pole sitter Paul Minnick ends up second. He tried everything he could to gain on Hanley. It just did not work. Jay Parker, your points leader. He keeps the points lead in third. Fourth, Crash B Fan. And fifth, Tommy Turbo. Grace Acevedo is sixth. Seventh is John Gambit. 8th Levi Jones, 9th Michael Gregory, and Luke Rainey, 10th. So there's your top 20. A pretty, really calm race here at Mid-Ohio. No cautions, no lead changes, or only one lead change, but same driver, really. And it's the only 39 cars could start the race. And Jonathan King was the one that missed the race, and that will definitely affect his points position as we will go look at the point standings now. Here are the point standings after 20 races. We are approaching the chase, and Jay Barker still has the points over TJ Henley, who is second with that win. He has locked himself into the chase. Jason Smales Jr. is third, Riley Sprague 4th, and Jeff Bright 5th. In 6th we have Tyler Lyman, 7th is Jim Gambit, 8th is Dale Petty, 9th is Paul Minnick, and 10th is Eli Bright. So there's your top 20. See right now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Those are your 12 winners. So right now the cutoff is Griffin Lynn. Lynn is tied with Jonathan Raines. However, Lynn with 2 wins is going to get that spot. So Chris Dodd right now on the bubble. Michael Gregory has gotten up. He's on the bubble. Hunter Arnsdorf. These guys are really close. Look at these winners. All within 100 points of each other. Jay Jefferson has a win. Grace Acefield has a win. Let's look at Grace Acefield. 21.73. Jonathan Raines has 21.08. That is less than a race away from each other. And then we look down even farther. You can see Jonathan King, after missing this race, after winning Indy, we thought he was pretty well into the chase. He falls out, so he's going to have to gain points or get another win. Same with Josh Crash. Alex Stewart falls 34th. Anthony Wendler 39th. I don't even think he can make the chase at this point, even if he wins the next few races. So it's going to be wild. TJ Henley winning this race just completely changed the picture of how this chase is going to go. And now the next race is the Sharpie 250 at Bristol. See you guys then.